Thank you very much for joining us. Storm Watch 9 weather on the web, moving towards the end of the week and the weekend. And by now, of course, you've heard all about Hurricane Lee, which of course is moving north right now at about 15 miles per hour based on the latest motion. Should make it pass well west of Bermuda between now and early on your Friday morning. Beyond then, the track continues to the north, and then sometime later Friday, Friday night, early Saturday, it may try to arch a little bit closer back towards the New England coastline, and then later on Saturday morning or early afternoon, get churned out to the east due to some gusty winds in the jet stream driving it in that direction. So, based on the latest track, which is really not much of a change from earlier projections in the last 48 hours, looks like the heaviest rain stays offshore. Now, this storm goes between a hurricane and what we call a post-tropical storm. Becomes almost akin to like a typical nor'easter that we see up here during the late fall, winter, and early spring. And based on that, the wind field will likely expand farther to the north and west, impacting parts of the Granite State. So in terms of our impact weather, since we're going to get brushed by the western side of Lee Saturday, there is a chance of wind gusts over 40 miles per hour. Best shot of that will be at the coastline, possibly some of the higher terrain in the White Mountains. Showers, but heaviest of the rain, staying off to our east, and clearly the greatest impacts right near the coastline. Because of that, tropical storm warning is in effect, kicks in pre-dawn hours of Saturday morning and goes right through Saturday evening. Winds out of the north, eventually northwest, 40 plus miles per hour, significant splash over and beach erosion near the middle and high tides, which is centered around midnight or a little after tomorrow night and early afternoon on Saturday. Enhanced rip currents out there now, right through the second half of the weekend, even when Lee pulls away. So in terms of the high wave heights, they're going to be significant, kicking on shore anytime between now and Friday up to about 3, 4, 5 feet, but really peaking by early on Saturday. In terms of the timeline for the rain itself, well, again, heaviest looks to stay offshore, but showers may work in from time to time early Saturday morning, well after midnight, tomorrow night, and on and off into Saturday afternoon before the storm races away later Saturday night with a beautiful second half to our weekend. So a lot of sun and low humidity hanging around as we go through time. So you'll notice in satellite imagery earlier on Thursday evening, we had a lot of dry air building in. Clouds up north will give way to clearing. And temperatures, yeah, they're going to tumble quite a bit overnight tonight with such dry air in place. So for Friday, even despite Lee making a close run at New England and the Canadian Maritimes, dew points stay low. So that's actually going to help undercut some of the real heavy rain and keep it offshore to our east. Little bump by Monday, and that brings in the next shot of showers in many parts of the state after whatever we see for showers on Saturday. So overnight tonight, 40s up north, 50 to 55 on south, nice low humidity through a nice looking Friday. Having said that, quite a few high clouds begin to build in, but it does stay dry. Then showers break out Saturday, pre-dawn hours, right through Saturday afternoon and early evening. Some gusty winds, especially closer to the coastline, but winds could gust up to 35 to 40 in some parts of interior New Hampshire. Bright, breezy, pleasant on Sunday, showers on Monday, and right now Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday are looking good.